Hello everyone, welcome. You know, after the food break, it is so difficult to continue with the training, but let us continue. Okay, so the next topic is generics. So anyone in this class who is aware of generics? Yes. Anyone? Don't say you are not aware of generics. You have been using generics day and night, I'm sure. You know, whenever you are doing like this list of something, you are using generics already, right? Anyone? Yes. That's sad. Okay, fine. So let me explain you what is generics here. First thing, you know, a lot of people think that generics is actually generics collection. Means a lot of people think that, okay, this is generics. List of string is generics, you know, but it is not. Generic and generic collections are actually two different things. Generic is a concept and generic collection is one of the implementation of that concept. So let us first try to understand the generics concept. Okay, so if you understand the generic concept, then generic collection is very easy to understand. Take the simple case here. Let us say you have a simple compare function. Okay, it's a simple compare class, I'm sorry. And this class compare, what it does is it actually compares numeric values. So let us say I have a function which returns boolean, and what it does is it actually takes two numbers here, num1 and num2, and it compares num1 with num2. Okay, so depending on scenarios, he returns true or he returns false. So you have a very simple compare function which returns true and false depending on scenarios, right? And if you wish to use this compare function in any client, what you're going to do, you're going to go and create a compare object like this, right? So you'll go and create a compare object, and then you will say obj.check, and then 40 comma of 20 or whatever, right? You pass in the two numbers and he will compare and give you the output saying it is true or saying it is false. Now, if you logically visualize this situation, we have two things here. One is we have the logic of checking. So we have a logic which we have written called as check, which does the checking of two numbers. And the other one is, you know, to this logic, we have the data type. So you can see here at this moment, you know, to this check logic, we are passing a numeric data type. If you see at this moment, the logic and the data type, both of them are tightly coupled. Means I cannot go and say here, okay, now, can I go and say, okay, check between two objects? Can I go and say, okay, now go and check between two strings? Okay, can I go and say, go and check between some other different types of data type entities? I can't do that because at this moment, the check function actually hard-codedly does numeric comparison, right? How about, you know, if as a consumer of your component, I get the opportunity to go and define the data type when I create the object? How about if somewhere I can say, okay, use this compare function with string like this, or use this compare function with numbers or integers, right? So if as a client who is consuming your component, if I can get that opportunity to say that, okay, your logic is check, but the data type which I want to use is now strings. Okay, your logic is check, but at this scenario, I want to go and use numerics. So if I can decouple the logic and the data type, I would have better reusability. You know, I can also, you know, utilize that class in a better manner, right? And that's where generics comes into picture. Look at that word generics. Generics says that you want to create a logic which is of a very general data type. So how do you do it? So you can do the following here. So you will say here, okay, this class compare can compare any data type. So I'll give something called as any data type, right? And I will say here, so I'm going to go and compare any data type. And this I'll just say data one. Now this data one can be numeric, it can be object, right? So you can see now here what I've done is I've just said to this class, I have went ahead and I've said that any data type. When I say any data type, you know, now what the client can do is the client can go and say here, okay, I'm going to go and create the compare function, but the compare function, I'm going to go and use it as a numeric data type, with a numeric data type. So if you see now, when I do a I dot check, You can see now it's numeric. But if I go and say, okay, now I want to go and compare between two strings, let us say. So now if you do a I dot check, you know, now you are doing a comparison of two strings. You can see now it is string to string comparison. So generic actually helps you to decouple your logic from the data type. So now here, if you see, if I do like this, data one dot equals data two, right? So let us say if I'm doing a numeric comparison, compare numbers, int bj is equal to new compare. Let us say I'm doing a numeric comparison here. So it gives me, okay, compare your check. So let us say 40, 20, right? So you can see now the time I do numeric, it will do a numeric comparison. Okay, let us say boolean b, and let us say if I now create a compare with a string, right? So if I say something like this, string, okay, you will see now this obj1 does a string check, right? So that's what the use of generics is. The whole purpose of generics is to decouple your logic from the data type. Now this concept, you know, Microsoft has taken and applied it to collection. So collection is a logic, right? A logic to add items to a collection, to remove items from a collection, to update items into a collection. Now this is the logic, and to that, you know, we can go and say, okay, now go and apply a list of string, right? Or go and apply a list of integer, right? So the list is the logic, right? And to that we are attaching the data type. So I hope that this video clarifies, you know, what exactly is generics, you know, what it means, and also you can now differentiate between generic word and generic collection.